A former Yale University classmate of Brett Kavanaugh's described him as a frequent drinker and a heavy drinker at college. Charles Chad Ludington, who now teaches at North Carolina State University, said on Sunday that he is deeply troubled by what he claims is a blatant mischaracterization by Kavanaugh of his drinking. Ludington, who said in a statement that he was Kavanaugh's friend at Yale and used to drink with him, accused the Supreme Court nominee of being untruthful in his testimony to the Senate Judiciary Committee about the extent of his drinking in college. In addition to being a frequent and heavy drinker, Ludington said Kavanaugh was often belligerent and aggressive when drunk. On many occasions I heard Brett slur his words and saw him staggering from alcohol consumption, not all of which was beer, he said. When Brett got drunk, he was often belligerent and aggressive. On one of the last occasions I purposely socialized with Brett, I witnessed him respond to a semi-hostile remark, not by defusing the situation, but by throwing his beer in the man's face and starting a fight that ended with one of our mutual friends in jail. Ludington said he plans to speak to the FBI because he believes Kavanaugh downplayed the degree and frequency of his drinking during the Senate hearing. I can unequivocally say that in denying the possibility that he ever blacked out from drinking and in downplaying the degree and frequency of his drinking, Brett has not told the truth, he said. FBI agents have asked him to meet at the Bureau's Raleigh office on Monday, the New York Times reports. During the hearing on Thursday, Kavanaugh insisted that he had never blacked out from drinking alcohol. His chief accuser, Dr. Christine Blasey Ford, has claimed that Kavanaugh and his friend Mark Judge were intoxicated when he allegedly sexually assaulted her. Ford, a California university professor, detailed her claims during the hearing that Kavanaugh tried to rape her at a party in 1982. When the two were still high school teenagers. Kavanaugh's drinking has come under intense scrutiny since Ford's accusations became public. When he was pressed on Thursday at his hearing about his drinking habits in high school, Kavanaugh said, "My friends and I, boys and girls. Yes, we drank beer. I liked beer. I still like beer. The drinking age, as I noted, was 18, so the seniors were legal. Senior year in high school, people were legal to drink." While he admitted in his congressional testimony that there were probably occasions during his time at Georgetown Prep that he had consumed too many beers, a combative Kavanaugh denied he had ever gotten out of control or acted inappropriately toward women. "I liked beer," he said. "But I did not drink beer to the point of blacking out, and I never sexually assaulted anyone." It comes as Deborah Ramirez, who was the second woman to come forward with allegations against Kavanaugh from their time at Yale University, spoke to FBI agents on Sunday as part of their investigation. In her interview with agents, Ramirez detailed her allegation that Kavanaugh exposed himself to her at a party in the early 1980s. A person familiar with the matter who couldn't discuss the confidential investigation publicly said Ramirez also provided the agents with names of others who she said could corroborate her account. Ramirez alleges that Kavanaugh exposed his penis to her during a drunken party at a Yale University dormitory when they were undergraduates. Kavanaugh has denied both Ford's and Ramirez's allegations. Trump bowed to pressure from moderate Senate Republicans and ordered the FBI investigation after the hearing. The announcement by Ramirez's lawyer indicates that the FBI probe of Kavanaugh will look beyond allegations of attempted rape leveled against the conservative federal appeals court judge by Ford at a dramatic Senate hearing this week. On Saturday, NBC News reported that the White House had constrained the FBI investigation by limiting its parameters. Trump denied that story, tweeting that actually, "I want them to interview whoever they deem appropriate, at their discretion." White House spokesman Raj Shah said the Senate had set the scope and duration of the FBI probe, which is supposed to be wrapped up in a week. "The White House is letting the FBI agents do what they are trained to do," Shah said. Michael Avenatti, the attorney for a third Kavanaugh accuser, Julie Swetnick, said in an email to Reuters that his client has not been contacted by investigators